There is Oblivion City surrounded by the eternally snow-covered peaks of the Cordillera Real Mountains. Named centuries earlier, La Paz means peace. As the seat of government and third most populous city in Bolivia, with more than 816,000 inhabitants, the city of La Paz faces similar challenges plaguing humankind across the globe, such as poverty, violence, political instability, economic downturns, and the breakdown of the family, all of which have been exacerbated by the COVID-19 pandemic. Like people world over, its people seek peace and happiness. But the resilient residents of La Paz have a special group of people, uniquely qualified in the law and anxious to offer assistance to alleviate suffering and provide much needed help. Members of the recently created La Paz Bolivia chapter of the J. Reuben Clark Law Society provide countless hours of service, host outreach programs and legal clinics, feed and clothe the needy, and lend a sympathetic ear to those forgotten or marginalized. One of its members, Baymar Paye, is a tax attorney and university professor. He explains how it all started. As a chapter, we existed for 1.5 years. When we started, we only had 2 people in the whole group. Before long, we had 146 members. In our chapter, we have so many active members because of our desire to serve. There is just so much to do. It is beautiful. As a group, we feel useful to the people we serve. To be able to apply what I've learned to help others makes me happy. Let me share with you just a few of the remarkable pro bono service activities members of the La Paz Bolivia chapter put on this past year. As the COVID virus began to spread throughout Bolivia, the La Paz chapter went to work immediately, organizing an online forum to address the fluctuating job market. 800 people logged in. Labor law specialists and a judge gave free professional legal advice. Baymar explained how they used social media to spread the word. We just knew we had to find a way to help people, so we used Facebook. In Bolivia, we were one of the first groups to undertake a project such as this. It was surprising how many people showed up. We didn't think we'd get to help so many people. Then, realizing violence within the family was on the rise since COVID-related quarantine restrictions, the chapter organized a webinar for people who needed legal help. Judges and family law specialists answered more than 450 questions. This single event was responsible for a membership surge of women who wanted to use their law degrees to support other women. Baymar said, "At first, we were nervous to undertake an activity like this, but it turned out to be something extraordinarily beautiful. There are so many people in Bolivia that need our help. Many of them are women who suffer from domestic violence. These women cried with us as they told us their stories, and sometimes it was frustrating not being able to help these women even more." On November 25th, the International Day for Elimination of Violence Against Women, the La Paz chapter members teamed up with the Women in the Law Committee to host a free legal clinic to address issues of intrafamily violence. The team of valiant attorneys and law students from different faith traditions united to serve women in dire situations. They helped the women understand their rights and how to pursue legal action. And in severe cases, arrangements were made to start the legal process immediately. Christmas is a special time of year when we think more often of our Savior's life with all of the blessings we receive because of his sacrifice and compassion. Spurred on by their love of God and neighbor, members of the La Paz chapter held 2 service projects in December. First, the student chapter worked with local youth from The Church of Jesus Christ of Latter-day Saints for a Light the World initiative. They prepared and distributed hundreds of meals to the city's homeless, many of them children. The next service activity was simply called For the Smile of a Child. Many children had huge grins on their faces as they received toys, food, and clothes for Christmas. Baymar explained, "We wanted to do something different in the month of December, something we'd never forget. We feel inspired and motivated to be able to move forward with helping others through our service. We are a global law society and are so inspired and impressed by the incredible members of the La Paz Bolivia chapter and their leadership and service. It is remarkable that they have done so much in so short of time since being organized, not to mention that they have done so in a year paralyzed by the COVID-19 related restrictions. It is truly inspiring and certainly an example of pure religion, influenced by their deep religious convictions. Por estas razones, es un placer presentar el Premio de Servicio Público Franklin S. Richards al Capítulo de La Paz, Bolivia. Felicidades. For these and countless other reasons, we are pleased to award the 2021 Franklin S. Richards Public Service Award to the La Paz, Bolivia chapter of the J. Reuben Clark Law Society. Our heartfelt congratulations. We will now be pleased to watch a short video by Baymar Paye accepting this award on behalf of the La Paz Bolivia chapter.
Hola, saludos cordiales, amigas y amigos. Mucho gusto, soy Baymar Paye, presidente del capítulo La Paz Bolivia de la Sociedad Legal J. Reuben Clark. Estamos muy agradecidos por esta oportunidad que nos dan de poder recibir un reconocimiento con este premio tan especial y tan honorable que nos sentimos muy, muy humildes de recibirlo. El capítulo La Paz Bolivia es un capítulo muy especial, está conformado por hombres y mujeres muy especiales de distintas confesiones religiosas. Tenemos abogados y estudiantes de derecho que se han ido uniendo de poco a poco. Me acuerdo que hemos empezado solamente dos personas en un grupo de WhatsApp y pues hemos ido creciendo de poco a poco hasta llegar a más de 100 personas. Y lo que nos ha ayudado mucho a poder atraer personas al capítulo, pues ha sido las ganas de poder servir. Aquí en Bolivia no hay esta organización de estas características y pues es lo que nos ha motivado a muchas personas a unirse a nosotros. Creemos que el servicio nos bendice tanto a las personas que sirven como a las personas que servimos. Y el año 2020 ha sido un año de muchos desafíos, de muchas situaciones a nivel mundial y pues no ha sido un impedimento para que nosotros podamos brindar nuestros conocimientos legales a través de lo que son los medios electrónicos. Pues hemos abierto una página en Facebook y es una página que ha sido muy conocida a nivel en Bolivia y a nivel también internacional. Con pequeñas actividades hemos podido lograr grandes cosas, ¿no? Hemos podido crear eventos de derechos laborales, en un momento en que quizás muchas personas se sentían inseguras por su estabilidad laboral. Nosotros hemos podido invitar a autoridades judiciales, a abogados expertos para que puedan brindar cómo los trabajadores pueden asegurar sus derechos en este tiempo tan difícil. Así también hemos vivido momentos en que ha habido mucha violencia intrafamiliar en Bolivia. Muchas mujeres han sido golpeadas o han recibido algún tipo de situación difícil. Entonces hemos podido brindar eventos donde las mujeres puedan recibir orientación legal y cómo poder defender sus derechos. Así después, una vez que ha pasado el tiempo de lo que ha sido la pandemia, hemos organizado una clínica gratuita en una plaza muy conocida aquí en La Paz. Y pues esto ha permitido de que muchas personas puedan venir a poder solicitar ayuda en esto. Recuerdo que muchas mujeres no tenían miedo de poder acudir a nosotros y poder inclusive llorar y poder comentarnos los distintos tipos de violencia que sufrían. Ha sido un momento muy especial, pues después de la clínica legal nos hemos sentido muy, muy felices porque nos hemos sentido útiles a la sociedad. Y después de esa actividad pues han ido incrementándose más personas a la sociedad legal y es como una pandemia que hemos generado, pero una pandemia de poder servir, de poder generar más manos en esta ayuda. Creemos que es el comienzo, creemos que estamos empezando y pues esperamos seguir logrando marcar la diferencia en nuestro país y poder que el capítulo sea un referente de servicio, sea un referente de libertad religiosa y sea un referente de excelencia profesional, pues eso es lo que apuntamos. Sé que Dios obra milagros en la vida de las personas. Sé que Él no ha cesado de brindar ayuda a través de las personas y estamos muy felices de que seamos instrumentos en sus manos de poder brindar ayuda. A nombre de la sociedad legal, a nombre del capítulo La Paz Bolivia, les agradecemos mucho al Comité Internacional por este reconocimiento del cual nos sentimos humildes y esperamos seguir contribuyendo al objetivo de sociedad. Muchas gracias y que Dios bendiga a cada uno de nosotros en este gran objetivo.